Wrestling. Good morning. Happy Veterans Day. Let's get in the mix on Cabinet Company. We're going to stop and we'll talk. That gives me a chance to calm down and then change. And if you're still here, sir, at 20 after, I want to bring you on. Shout out to my friends and listeners over there on the Space Coast. We lost a great one. Rapping Ray all the way from L.A. Ray Cass's former owner of WMIE 91.5. 91 Jams. Oh my God, he's gone. Does that mean Mr. DJ's nine lives are over with? That's what I want to know.
Ah, damn it!
rhymes in it.
There's no point
there.
You got your
haircut?
Are you
still alive?
It's my
hair.
I know.
Cut! Well, this is gonna be tricky.
Listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill in the mix. Hell of a name.
Okay, we're gonna talk to that 22. Do I wanna go with? How do we want to do this? Why not go with
Let's go.
21 after the hour. Happy Veterans Day. I've got my one of my veteran hats on today as I salute veterans out there. Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard. Uncle Pauly hiding in the back as usual. That's all right.
I'm here.
That's okay, but see, you know, they can't see Uncle Pauly with this camera, with this one camera shot. But the
you can see me now.
The second camera I purchased yesterday.
You can see me now, right?
I actually, yes. I went online and I said I needed another Microsoft HD camera, and I didn't feel like paying full fare. Because some folks are saying now that the... they're making some snide remarks. And I'll just leave it at that. And I went and I scraped up this and I moved this from there and this went to there. And, oh my God, I can buy it. And then I went online and the person dropped his price. So we've got that. So next week we will have a two-camera shoot. I'll have the switcher right here. And oh my God, now all I got to do is just get somebody who knows how to do WordPress to revamp the site so that you'll
That's
be able to see video from the morning show, as well as I see LV the intern running around from WJHM 102 Jams, our sister station. So we will be very patriotic in covering everything, because we decided that since Washington and actually most of America, or the Electoral College representing the United States' people, said the first one to 270 wins. So Donald Jackass, I mean J. Trump, he got it. And there are people that are pissed. There are people that are really pissed. And so I decided to do something that actually some friends brought to my attention. One, Chris, get out of your comfort zone. Two, quit listening to what everybody else has to say. You got this far on gut feeling. So what does your gut tell you? Oh my God. My eyes will open wide open. This is my gut feeling. This man is going to give me 4 years, four more years of extending my broadcasting career, because he's going to do so much foolishness or stupidity that, boy, we've got, oh my God, you've got to see what I'm going to be wearing and doing on Captain and Company and the rest of the Aquarius 7 Broadcasting Network. So, people, I thoroughly am going to enjoy the next 4 years. Because I'm also going to enjoy the fact that Uncle Pauly has to defend him for the next 4 years. I don't have to defend diddly squat. My dog is not in that hunt. Even though he's probably barking because of the... DirecTV gentleman still working in the studio. Where is Reese? Is he hiding? Is he?
He's chilling.
He's doing something. He's minding his own business right now. Okay. Eric Range.
What's going on?
Art 420. Good morning, sir. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks for having me.
Now that black folks can smoke weed and now paint pictures with it, I figured, what the hell? I might as well make some money off of it. Because I know that the main broadcasters are too scared to take that money. I will take that money. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
This is very true. There's a huge debate over allowing companies that are in the cannabis industry to be able to advertise on, you know, mainstream media, whether it be Facebook, Google, and so on. So a lot of companies out there are having a difficult time. So, Captain, this might be your time to shine.
$500 a month, I will advertise all the reefer you want to talk about. I'm telling you, the child support people will love me. How did you pay your child support? With marijuana money. What the hell wrong with you? You damn right. Fire it up, Rick James. Oh, boy. Uncle Pauly.
Yes, sir.
Hold it. Why can't we get LV on the in the camera shot? LV, I know you're over
really
here.
Tight over there.
Oh, I'll hold it. Now, see, why don't you wave to the people? You're on. Okay, got your Cavs
jersey.
That's
my Miss America wave.
Oh, that's your Miss America wave. Okay, good. On this happy Veterans Day.
That camera's pretty dope. It's got like a 360 view on it.
Girl, wait till you see what... And the other one over there will have 360 views. See? See? We got it going on around here.
All right, Captain America.
All right, Pauly.
Yes, sir.
Before I get back into the mix on Veterans Day, would you please tell us what is going on in the country?
Well, last night they were rioting in Portland, Oregon, over the, you know, the Trump election, and I'm really upset about this when they actually go and loot stores and smash windows and everything, because those poor merchants, they had nothing to do with what's going on. I mean, they're just trying
to... Hold on. Were they old white people? If they were old white people, they voted.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
So if somebody smashed their window, what am I supposed to do?
Oregon,
am I supposed to feel sorry for them? Oregon, they voted for Trump. They voted for him.
Well, Oregon voted for Hillary. She won Oregon. She won Seattle, Washington. She won California. All the places where they really protested, those places she won.
Well, I hope they're not smashing my Asian brothers and sisters' stores. Leave them alone. They had nothing to do with this election.
And in Denver, they're getting on the highway, tying up 25.
Oh, well, look, stop. This is what they do all the time. Every time I'm in Denver, Colorado, they stop in the middle of I-25. I don't understand why. Right downtown, just between, there's an amusement park on the right, left-hand side, and then Sports Authority Field is like three or four exits down on the right. Every time I'm in Denver, and I'm talking about I've been there six times, they stop in the middle of the freeway.
Oh, no.
Makes no sense. I don't understand. Is it the marijuana in their system? Is it... I don't know. Maybe
I think that would make them stop.
Maybe it's this.
Beep, beep, beep. Looks like it's bumper to bumper on the interstate.
I don't know. Or is somebody screaming immigration and everybody's like, oh, my God. I don't know.
So in New York, the protests were limited last night. It was way down because they have Trump Tower protected by armed security and police, so they can't get to that.
Oh,
so.
Poor guy. I'm supposed to feel sorry for him.
Well, I don't understand. It's like,
I'm supposed to feel sorry for that bastard?
If
really?
I were the protesters, I would have waited for him to take office and done something that they hated before they just did it now. Because he hasn't even done anything yet. He's not even in power yet.
But, Paulie, this is what's going to happen.
But they don't
this
know
This is
that.
What's going to happen. If this is starting off like this right now, could you imagine what's going to happen January 20th?
But is it, although I think
can you help me? Can you know what's going to happen on February 15th? Wow.
I think they're giving him a mandate, you know, because of what they're doing.
What's he going to do? Martial law? Really? It's already martial law.
See what they did to the guy in Chicago?
What did they do to him?
The guy in Chicago. This guy's a stupid white guy. I would not be driving to the south side of Chicago with a Trump bumper sticker on my car at night. You're a dumbass white guy.
Hey, he said it this time, it wasn't me.
So hey, pretty much you gotta, you're a dummy, I mean, you know.
What happened to him?
They took him out and beat him.
Yeah, sounds about right.
They should have, look, they should have torn and feathered him. Oh my God, what is your people, Paulie, up tidy and pasty doing?
They're happy last time I talked to them because they won.
Yeah.
So what's going on downtown Orlando tonight? I heard there's going to be
a protest at Lake Eola.
Good.
I just hope that protest doesn't go up to downtown and there's pillaging and looting. I hope that there's, you know, if they just keep it down at Lake Eola, it's a peaceful protest.
That's crazy that they're going to have a protest downtown in Lake Eola, and then tomorrow is the Pride Festival, so it's going to be a quick change of energy from tonight to tomorrow. You have some angry people down there not happy about the presidential election and not happy about who their president is, and then tomorrow, people who are celebrating their gay rights and people who are... have torn feelings about the massacre that happened here in Orlando. So, you know, it's not going to be the greatest... I don't know. I guess tomorrow could be more positive than negative. But tonight, I would hope that in the light of all the people's negative feelings, there could be some sort of positivity. If people coming together for a cause, I mean, that's good. I guess a lot of people who have the same beliefs are allowed to share that.
Well, I'm blaming the media for a lot of this problem, because the media had all these people thinking that Hillary was going to win. That's why I think a lot of people didn't go out and vote. And they, oh, I don't have to vote.
I see where you're coming from, but also I feel like Trump dug his own grave. Like, he is not the best role model for a lot of Americans. So he made this who he is, this kind of person he is. Nobody made up his comments. Nobody told him to say all these things and be the way he is. That's the kind of person
he
is.
Well,
he
had
is.
To say those things to win the Republican nomination. I mean, he was against all these other guys that were, you know, against gay marriage and they're.
I don't think you go discriminating women or talking bad about women to win a Republican nomination. I think that's just the type of person he is.
Well,
he
doesn't care what people think about him. The thing that they had on the Access Hollywood, that was back in 2005.
It doesn't matter when it is. I'm sure you did something in 2005.
Well, he wasn't running for president back then.
Doesn't matter. It's still who he is. It's the kind of person he is. It's your character, your demeanor, your morals, your standards.
Well, I think he's a rich guy that dealt entitlement,
There's no entitlement whether you're rich or not. You're just a poor person at heart. That's what he is, and I don't like him representing me at all. He wants to be president of the United States. Go right ahead. If I had any more in me and I was around a whole bunch of people who were protesting in Oregon or whatever it is, I'd be right there with them. I don't want him as my president. It doesn't make me happy, and it doesn't sit well not only with people in Oregon, but people all over the world. You have children, kids that are in colleges, leaving out of their classes, protesting, marching down the block saying this isn't my president. They're not happy. You have people who, okay, yeah, they voted for Hillary, but they're crying in tears. You know why they're crying? Not because Hillary isn't president, because they fear for their future of who's going to lead them throughout the United States. It's bigger than just, okay, he's a bad person, and now it's bigger than all that. And you got to think for the people themselves, every single individual in the United States is... It's not the same person. Everybody has a different point of view.
You know what? I can sum it all up. Can we please bring back
Franklin Delano?
That's what we need to do. That'll just take care of all of that.
Well, I'll tell you right now, the Democrats kind of like set themselves up. They like crooked Hillary, and she screwed Bernie Sanders. You know that. Everything they did with delegates, and also with, you know, with Donna Brazile did, working with CNN, feeding her the questions and all that. So, I mean, they screwed the guy that probably would have been able to beat Trump. Because Bernie Sanders had no baggage.
Yeah.
I mean, he had no scandal. And he was out to help the millennials. He was up to help the poor white people in Ohio and Michigan. Trump would have not gotten all those votes if Bernie would have been in there. So, hey, you put up a bad candidate, you get what happens, you know.
Well, this is how I kind of look at it, too. So, let's kind of summaze it like this.
I'd blow up the pipes. I'd blow up the roof. I'd blow up every single inch. There would be nothing left.
So, you know, now he's got hell to pay. So, 34 after the hour, Captain and Company, let's get back into the mix on this Veterans Day.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
You're listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill in the mix.
Texas, stage left.
Tonight is something that we really haven't seen before.
I'd blow up the pipes, I'd blow up the roof, I'd blow up every single inch, there would be nothing left. And you can tell them to go themselves.
Get that out of here. How about...
Just cause it's
10 minutes. Now give me 5 minutes. No, let's do that. Radio Network, San Francisco, the Bay Area, Oakland, good morning, San Jose, all the way down to LAX, also our friends out in Denver, check us out, we've got video running, this will be uploaded to Facebook shortly, and I've got my construction hat on, and everybody's like, well, why do I have my construction hat on? Somebody's got to boss these people around when they build this wall. You know, somebody's got to be the El Jefe, boss man. Hey, boss man, boss man. Come here, boss man. Could you tell me how deep this trench needs to be before we put the wall up, boss man? You know, hey, boss man. Can I smoke some reefer on the job, boss man? Hey, boss man. Boss man. Boss man. You know, I hate people that do that. Don't you? They sit up there, they kiki, and they're boss man. That's all they say.
That's it.
That's it.
That's all they have.
You know,
to say
sound like it. Some. I can't even say it right now. 41 after the hour, Captain McCombie, Uncle Paulie.
You know, I saw Cornell Gordon. Yes, you know Cornell, right?
Cornell, yeah.
He's very upset because he's afraid that the Klan is going to be back big time, and he might have a really legitimate fear. Because I'm looking online here in North Carolina in Charlotte on the 3rd, they're going to have a KKK parade. KKK parade for a victory thing for Trump, so he might have a legitimate fear.
That sounds like mayhem to me. I don't think people fear the KKK. I think the KKK should fear the people.
LV, slide over this way a little bit. Slide to the right. Keep coming. There you go. There you go. Slide to the right here. Now, you know, this conversation is just absolutely, what's the word I want to say? It's craziness. I mean, it's like America, everything we've worked for in the last, I don't know, 40, 50 years, 60 years, gone. Gone in one fell swoop. Now, we have a gentleman in the studio that did some work for our DirecTV service, so now it's back up and running. Good morning, sir. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Now, to the mic, Brad.
Yeah. Oh, you know who we are? You know Brad?
Of course, I introduced myself to him already.
Okay. Well, tell us what Brad, I mean, what does he do besides being the DirecTV guy?
Brad works for DirecTV, and he's also a, I would say a rapper on the side. He hasn't had an opportunity to actually work in a studio yet and do some actual production work. So what I'd like him to do is come on my indie jam show, which airs over on our sister station WJHM102jams.com every Tuesday from 6 to 8 p.m. and do a lot of freestyle, and hopefully all the people that I work with, as far as the producers, the engineers, everyone that will be listening to my show, will discover some new talent and be willing to work with him.
Wow. See, that's what happened. You stumbled into something there, pal. Now.
He's got a dope tattoo of a boombox, and it says "Be Ready" on it.
Be ready.
Be ready.
Yeah.
How did you know he had a tattoo?
He showed me.
You know, I'm kind of like, I'm scared to ask about his damn tattoo.
It's on his arm.
Oh, it's on his arm. Even the CEO is a player here. How did you know about this guy's tattoo?
Oh, gosh. You guys are so extra.
No, we're not.
I'm level 2. You just took it to 10.
Well, you know, look, it could be a level 11 if I keep ringing it.
Nobody wants the phone service.
You know.
We're good.
Okay.
But it just shows that a part of him is obviously dedicated to music. If you go get a tattoo of some, even a musical instrument or musical symbols or anything that has to do with music, it just shows that it's a true passion of yours. And it's always interesting when you meet people like that and you can help them dig deeper and find their true meaning in music and what direction it is they want to go in, especially if you can help them get to another level that they didn't even know they could get to.
Okay, so it sounds like to me at 44 after the hour, you want to put him on and see if he can go freestyle with this beat. Is that what you're trying to
Not
say?
Not this beat. You need a hip-hop beat. We need a new bed. You got some Drake? There?
Oh my god. You know that damn panda crap.
It's not panda, it's hype.
I can't stand that, but let's see, what do we have? D R A K.
Try energy.
Why don't we just give him the Drake bit?
Why don't you just do energy? It's a really good beat.
Energy?
Yep.
You want to freestyle now?
Yes.
Alright,
so
be ready.
Dude, anything is possible around here. If Donald J. Trump can get elected, you can be live on the radio.
Yeah,
just that quick.
That's
time.
Right, do whatever you want. The gunshot means forward. You requested it, so here you are.
Yeah. Way up. Turn it all up. Yeah. Look, I got enemies, got a lot of enemies, got a lot of people trying to drain me on my energy, they trying to take away from a
boy's kid and pray.
Yeah, it's playing, we're waiting on you.
No, that's not instrumental.
I don't have the instrumental.
I do.
I don't have time to cue it up.
I can't rap over Drake.
You can rap over Drake. Right, look, watch this. See, this is what happens when you let the millennials come in and try to get involved in the grown folks show. Let the grown folks do what we know how to do. Now, he should be able to rap to this. Come on, man. Show me what you got.
I got no sound in the headphones.
You got no sound in the headphones. Okay, turn up the headphones. Turn it up. There you go. Turn it up.
All right. I don't know if I can rap on this beat.
Give him Panda.
Take this beat or don't take it at all. We're live.
I do a lot of old school hip hop beats, but I could try this like DJ Premier and stuff, but like I might be able to do this.
Okay, anytime.
It's a little too slow.
Trying to teach the millennial that the old man does know what the hell he's doing. All right, let's go back to the grown folks. All right, here we go.
Oh,
all right.
Your boss is coming.
Uh-oh. Now the boss is coming, so that took care of the fun we were going to have.
He almost didn't lose his job.
He's got to get back to work.
I wasn't trying to make the man lose his job now.
He was just providing customer service.
Don't quit your day job.
Yeah, that was
quality
good customer,
customer service.
That was good.
Yeah,
trying to do quality customer service. All right, so with y'all out here, and we're still trying to do a live radio show at 47 after the hour. Eric, what's going on, man? Tell me a little bit more about 420 Art.
So, yeah, we have Art 420, the second annual cannabis-inspired art show coming up this Thanksgiving weekend. So if you're in town in Orlando, Florida on Thanksgiving weekend, come down to the Hanau Contemporary Center on Edgewater Drive. That'll be taking place again November 25th, 26th, and 27th at the Hanau Contemporary Center. It's free and open to the public. It's a art show that is all about the subject of cannabis. And since we passed Amendment 2 here in Florida, this is specifically for those who supported this. Even if you didn't support it, come out, talk to some people who did, and maybe you'll get a different perspective on it. Art 420 is all about challenging the stereotype of cannabis users as lazy and unproductive, and opening dialogue and sparking conversation about this plant that has helped so many, that's been a part of our culture for so long, and really and truly has been nothing but positive for us. So we're trying to change that stereotype. Art 420 again, November 25th, 26th, and 27th at the Hanau Contemporary Center.
Nice. Is that an outdoor event? That's going to be indoor.
This is an indoor event. Hanau Contemporary Center is an actual gallery.
So when I open the doors, it's going to be like a puff of smoke.
Paulie will be passing it along. Puff, puff, pass Paulie.
Imagine walking in, it's just like,
but here's what I'll say to that. You know, Amendment 2 did not legalize adult use, and so I caution everyone still that this is only for.
It's gonna smell really good in there. That's what it is.
Well, you know, actually,
cool some scents, like some people I know they do like candles,
the
they
incense
have all different
and so on. Yeah,
like
absolutely.
The car fresheners.
Absolutely.
And, I don't know, cool things like that. But well, I do know a lot of people my age that this would be something. That I could see them being interested in. So
well,
I will definitely help you promote over.
I appreciate that. We love to come on and love to spread the word about it. This is a family-friendly event. Last year's show, again, with it still, we just passed medical marijuana here in the state, but in terms of recreational and adult use, it's still illegal. So at our show, we don't really have any smoking or anything like that.
Yeah.
We kids are invited to come out. This is a good opportunity for parents to be able to have a conversation with their kids about cannabis, using the fine art. So again, we use the art to be able to spark dialogue and conversation. And a couple things that we're doing also this year that are different than last year.
I'm sorry, that's a cool slogan. Use the art to spark. That's dope.
Well,
yeah.
We are a highly creative culture. You know, that's the other part of our slogan, highly creative culture.
Use the art to spark.
Absolutely. This year, one of the things we're doing, you know, now that the cannabis industry is coming here to Florida, well, it's already been here in Florida, we're trying to encourage minorities to get off the sidelines, to get into, the medical marijuana industry, cannabis industry, and to also get behind legalization. You know, it's decimated the communities of color and communities of poverty with the war on drugs, and yet these are the individuals who aren't behind the legalization movement and who aren't reaping the economic benefits as this thing becomes legal. So on November 26th, we're going to be having a black market brunch for anybody who is interested in actually getting into the cannabis industry. So if you are a minority professional, minority business owner, or investor, this is the event that you want to come out. We got a list of speakers. We got a grower from Oregon, Jesse Horton, who is the chair of the Minority Cannabis Business Association. He'll be there talking to you guys about his experience. And he's an engineer by trade. He had an extensive career as an engineer for about 10, 15 years and decided to leave that career and go into the cannabis industry. So, this may be for a lot of you folks out there who haven't been sure how you can get into the industry. There's ways for you to use your skills that you already have to be able to serve this industry. So come out to the Black Market Brunch. Again, go to our website, art420.com. You can spell it out. 420 is spelled out. And you'll find all the information about the art show, about the Black Market Brunch. We're really just trying to get minorities into this game.
Okay, we'll talk more about Art 420 with Eric Range coming up next hour. Also, the big show at MLR Automotive tomorrow. But first, can I get back in the mix, please, on Captain Company?
Hello?
Hello, may I speak to Lazy?
Yo, listen, what's up? Yo, Lazy, this is Jay, man.
Oh, yeah, what's up, man?
Nothing, me and DJ Lynn just over here cooling out, man.
Oh, yeah, Danzo?
Yeah. Yo, you remember that kid Joe from round the way?
Yeah, I remember.
Yo, man, the Avalanche just took that boy away, man. And just the other day, me and Lynn saw him on the corner. We was telling him. We said, yo, man, you need to get yourself off the corner. You know what I'm saying? You need to do something positive with your life. Huh? Get yourself together. You know what I'm saying?
He's still
rolling it up.
No. Yo, but tell me something, John.
He walked out.
This man, and everybody keep yelling, yelling.
They pop up every now and then. But, like, I've been going through, like, personal issues. Like, my girlfriend just broke up with me. So he was just coming just to see how I was doing.
Though the face is still my beat, he might got towed away somewhere. But I ain't care nothing about that, man, because I'm all about
it. Well, I don't have too much great advice on Bluetooth, so I can say that I just can't use it in a positive light.
I've written more stuff in the past 2 weeks than I have in the past year.
I mean, I used to go through so much, like, writing was like my best friend, my friend, you know? Helping
me
out all my feelings and everything. I wasn't
so
much.
Like,
you wouldn't
believe it, because now I talk so much.
Oh, it's sports. But I was going
to be really
fine. Can you stick around? I'm here, man. Have you heard this song before? Yeah. It's in my car. I used to work in a music store when I was in high school, man. So, you know, like, late 90s.
But I guess I'm not doing anything.
You know, a lot of music was still good.
Yo, man, it's like I told you once before, you know what I'm saying? You don't know what time it is. You out here on the streets and you don't know what time it is. You know what I'm saying? Brothers is losing their lives, they're losing their minds. We part of a system that's holding us back mentally.
Write it down for me afterwards because I'm going live right now. So when I'm done, I'll tag you.
All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, cool.
You're listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill.
Okay, we're gonna do sports, Paulie.
Alright.
Paulie, look at me. When we do sports, it's not going to be the sports bed. It's going to be one of the marches.
What?
Marches. It's gonna be one of the marches. You're not gonna have the sports bed.
Okay.
What's your Instagram?
Oh. Also, can you add your vegan?
Big shout out to my friends and listeners, NAS Road of Spain. Thanks for being on board. My goodness, it is Veterans Day, and since it's Veterans Day, Uncle Paulie has to do his sports today. Yes. So, Paulie,
yes,
give me your scores first before we pick our games.
Okay. Well, last night we had a football game in Beemore, as the Ravens beat the Browns 28-7, so the Browns remain the only winless team in the NFL at 0-10.
Now, you know, at one point the score was 7-6, Paul.
Yes.
But the Browns.
But the Ravens.
And it scared the hell out of me.
It scared the hell out of me.
I've been losing stuff all week, and I don't need to lose another one.
No, the Ravens came through.
Okay, good, good.
All right, let's go to the NBA. It was the Pelicans over the Bucks, 112-106. Dwayne Wade returns to Miami with the Chicago Bulls and beats the Heat 98-95. The Warriors over the Nuggets 125-101. And the Lakers beat the Kings 101-91. The Lakers look like they're getting their...
They got their act together. Yeah, real deal.
In NCAA football, is North Carolina over... No, Duke over North Carolina 28-27.
So Duke did win.
Yeah, Duke
did win. Because my DirecTV was working then, and I saw the very end of that.
And Utah beat Arizona 49-26.
Arizona sucks.
Yes.
Aren't they a red state? They ended up being a red state.
Yes, they did.
They suck. All right, so 59.
Okay, in NHL, it was the Wild over the Penguins 4-2. Canadians over the Kings 4-1. It was the Red Wings over the Canucks 3-1. And the Predators over the Blues 3-1.
Okay, now, before we do football.
Yes.
This young man with the boombox is still in studio. And he wants to try his wants to rap. So, I'm going to give him a beat. And if he goes with the beat, fine. If he doesn't go with the beat, then I don't know what to tell you. I'm going to pick the beat. It's real simple. Real simple. I want to see, can he do it? Because this is something I'm trying to educate with Elvy. If you're good, you can go with any beat. Am I correct? Are they, Eric?
I will keep
if
sure.
You're good, you can go. You can flow with anything. And we're going to make
I
it
think
so.
Be Ready is ready now.
Be
he
Ready
is ready now.
From B, is he from Beemore? Is Be Ready from Beemore? Are you ready, Beemore?
I'm ready.
Be Ready. Watch this. If he can't, look, he's got to be able to do this. Come on. Come on. Anybody can do this one. Let me hear you.
All right. All right. I'm in the studio. Yo. All right. I'm a little nervous. There's no cursing. I'm just trying to get my money, I'm always splurging. I'm always into something because it's always real urgent. I'm just trying to keep on moving, keep on swerving. Going into the median, as I'm trying to speed on them as I go through. I'm trying to tell you something as I'm not selling my soul. I'm just trying to keep on going, always trying to flow, always flowing. I never even know it's off the top of the head, so when I drop dead you gon' see that I never stop getting fed as I'm trying to keep on feeding these beats into my mental. I'm chipping my dental as I'm ripping instrumentals. Keep on going, keep on flowing. Always bite down when I come through the hype sound. You might get slight now as I come through off the top of the building. Let the children know, let everybody know. I don't care about Trump, no, no.
Play the Patriots in the Super Bowl. That's gonna be our highest rated Super Bowl ever. The boys and the Patriots.
My hat's off to you, brother.
That was a damn good job.
I want to see you when you're at Indie Jams.
Yeah, we gotta get you sign him up for Indie Jams there. LV, oh my god. That's
talent. We're working on his schedule right now. We're trying to squeeze him in.
Okay.
Have to work schedule.
You gotta call his boss for
Hey, boss man. Can I get on the Captain's radio show?
Can I get on
the LV show? Boss man, please!
That's how his job works. You get jobs sometimes that don't work out like you're supposed to do when you gotta go through attics and stuff and you get held up. So
I think my favorite part was chipping my dental, blowing through these instrumentals or something like that. I was like, oh, alright.
I was like, wow.
Wait till you get on Indie Jams. I mean, that beat was nice, but I'll give you a nice beat, something that you could work with and really give you a chance to explore your vocabulary. Because it sounds like you could really rip through.
He can handle his own. Yeah. That young man can handle his own. Give him a nice round of applause, everybody.
Great job.
Alright, now we got to keep it moving.
Be ready for Be Ready for Be Ready, yo.
Okay, now, with Be Ready, from Be Ready to Be More to... Alright, Uncle Pooh, only time to pick them games.
Alright, the first game we've got Sunday is the Packers are playing the Titans. And Green Bay is favored by 2.5. I think Green Bay is not what they were, but I don't think they've fallen that they can't beat the Titans. I'm taking the Packers.
You know what, Paulie? You know, I've lost a lot of things this week, and I might even have one of them. I'm working on getting one of them back. And with that said, I'm going for an upset. I've got to turn it around this week. I got to go with Tennessee. All right, so now, who else we got up there?
Next one is a game that you care about. It's in FedEx Field in Washington. The Vikings travel down to play the Redskins. The Vikings have lost 3 in a row, and Washington's favored by 2.5. I'm taking Washington because I think the Vikings aren't right now.
Going with my Redskins, yes, even though Donald Trump is in office. I can't lose again to anybody else if I'm going to make it in the playoffs. Sorry, Paulie, who's next?
The Bears travel down to Raymond James Stadium to play the Buccaneers. The Bears are favored by 1 in this game on the road. I find out, I mean, the Bucs have been bad, but I would think they got a rebound this week.
Paulie. They gotta beat the Bears. Oh my god, if not Bad Butchie Brown, he's gonna commit suicide jumping off the Skyway Bridge. Oh my god! Curse splash.
Alright, the next game is the Chiefs travel down to North Carolina to play the Panthers. The Panthers are favored by 3. I think the Panthers have righted their ship. I think they're gonna win this game. They're favored by 3 at home, and they played a lot better the last couple weeks. I'm gonna go with the Panthers. The Chiefs are the better team. They're 6-2.
Just because I'm playing the Pink Panther bed does not mean that I am taking the Carolina Panthers, people. I'm taking the Kansas City Chiefs to win this one. All right, okay, who's next?
This game's Battle of the Birds. The Falcons travel up to Philadelphia to take on the Eagles. The Falcons are favored by 2 in the road. I think the Eagles are kind of like hit a wall right now. I'm going to take the Falcons on the road.
You're taking the Falcons?
Yeah.
Over the
Eagles.
Eagles. And they're playing where?
In Philly.
In Philly. And somebody's trying to call in while we're doing a live radio show, as usual. Hold on a minute. Since Eric from Art 420 is here to promote smoking pot and painting, which is legal in Florida, I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to stop the music like this, and I'm going to take. I'm going to act like I'm rolling up something.
Need to get your medical marijuana card.
Yeah, I got my medical marijuana card right here. See what it says? Art 420 is my medical marijuana card. Leave me alone. I'm going to take Atlanta on that one, the Dirty Birds, baby.
All right, in the next game, there's two bottom feeders playing each other. The Rams travel to New York to play the Jets. One, Rams are 3-5, the Jets are 3-6. They're both bad. I think I'd take the Jets at home. I think the Jets should be good enough to win at home.
J-E-T-S, Jet. Hey, man, I'm hungry, man. You got me smoking the reefer, man. I got to get me something to eat, man. Where them Doritos at? Who's next, Paul?
All right, the Broncos are traveling down the Big Easy to take on the Saints. Saints are favored by 3 as well. I'm going to take the Saints at home. I think the Saints are playing a lot better. At home, they're pretty tough.
You know what? This is what happens when you smoke pot. Woo, my head kind of dizzy and I'm kind of woozy. I can roll me another great big fat newbie. All right, who else?
All right, the Texans are traveling down to Jacksonville to play the Jags.
Oh, and I gave you those tickets.
Yeah, the Jags are favored by 2 in this game. I don't think the Jags should be favored over anybody in this league except the Browns. The Jags should be favored over the Browns. Nobody else.
Come on, man.
The Texans.
Paulie, the Jacksonville Jaguars hook us up with media passes.
Well, I'm not.
They give you free food. I mean, come on. They charge you $40 to park your car. Give me a break. You should be going with the Jaguars.
I don't know who I think is going to win.
Okay, all right. Who else we got over there?
All right, the Dolphins are going out to San Diego to play the Chargers.
Oh, boy.
The Dolphins are on a little bit of a roll, but I'll tell you now, they've never done well in California. And this is a back-to-back Southern California for the Dolphins, because they got to play Rams out there next week.
So they might as well just stay out there.
They are going to do that.
Okay.
San Diego's favored by 4. I'm going to take San Diego. With that. Dolphins have never done well on the West Coast.
All right. 2, 3, 4. Superchargers! Chargers! Superchargers, San Diego! Chargers, Chargers! Alright, yeah, alright. That sounds like it came from a discotheque from the 70s, for crying out loud.
Okay, the next one is the Cowboys travel up to Pittsburgh and take on the Steelers.
Oh, boy!
The Steelers are favored by 2.5. I'm going with the boys. I think the boys are the better team and the hotter team.
Look, I know you smoking now. I know you smoking some reefer now.
The boys are 7-1.
I don't give a damn.
The Steelers are 4-4.
I don't give a damn. They could be undefeated, them cowgirls. I mean, boys, that's the most offensive name I've ever heard in my life. I'm offended by Donald Trump. I'm offended by dumb people. And I'm really offended by the Dallas Cowboys, and I'm going with black and yellow on that one.
And next month's the big game of the week. The rematch.
Be quiet. Don't be disrespecting the song. Black and yellow. Black and yellow. Yeah. Black and yellow, yeah. Black and yellow, motherfucking black and yellow. There you go. Black and yellow, gonna stump them cowboys. Yeah. Ben Russell, Roethlisberger's gonna stump the black and yellow. Yeah. Ben Roethlisberger and the boys are gonna do it.
Are you freestyling now?
Yeah. I am high. That is why I am trying to rap it now. Okay. And last but not least, Paulie.
Well, it's not the last. We got two more.
Oh, my God.
Last game on Sunday is rematch of Super Bowl 49. The quarterbacks who have the hottest wives in the league. The Seahawks travel to New England to take the Patriots. Patriots are favored by 7.5. I'm going with the Patsies at home.
Paulie.
Yes.
Just because you won the presidential election doesn't mean you're going to keep winning football games. I'm telling you right now, the Chicken Hawks upset.
Okay. And another game, Monday night game, the Giants travel. The Giants don't travel. They're home at MetLife Stadium to take on the Cincinnati Bengals. This will be a hard game for the Giants because I think the Cincinnati Bengals got a really good offensive, defensive line.
Okay, some people are really going to pay attention to this pick. Listen to who I'm taking. Mama San's New York Giants are going to win.
Well, the game is even. The odds makers.
Did you hear me?
Yes.
Mama San's New York Giants are going to win.
I'll take the Giants.
All right. Anything else?
Now, that wraps up our NFL picks for the week. Everybody have a great weekend. This is Paulie.
You know, your car only runs as well as you treat it. So why not bring it to the professionals at MLR Automotive Transmission and Air Conditioning Incorporated, where they treat every customer like their family. I drive an old car. It's 16 years old. It's got more than 200,000 miles on it. It runs good, but it needs a little help every now and then. That's why I turned to MLR. With over 16 years of experience, MLR provides the Orlando area with quality automotive repairs and transmission service at unbeatable prices. MLR is also an air conditioning specialist. Their ASC certified technicians work with all types of makes and models and count on them for fleet service as well. Free towing is available with repairs, and when the job is done, they'll even wash your car for free as well. Now that's treating you
right. 25 is when we're going to stop again.
All the care it needs to run smoothly and safely at MLR Automotive Transmission and Air Conditioning Incorporated. Call Mark and the gang today, 407-331-4657. That's 407-331-4657.
If you're free tomorrow, you ought to come by.
4300 Aloma Avenue, right on the corner of Old Howe Branch Road in Aloma Avenue.
Join us Saturday, November the 12th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. for our customer appreciation party. Free hot dogs, hamburgers, music, chance to win concert tickets, and meet the online personalities from the Aquarius 7 Broadcasting Network. And, of course, get your ride checked out. MLR Automotive's Customer Appreciation Party, Saturday, November the 12th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m.
1800 Entertainment and 719 Nightlife present Red Carpet Soul Jam, featuring Donnell Jones with Silk and Colorado Springs' own Tony Exum Jr., hosted by Rodney Perry, November 11th at the Colorado Springs City Auditorium. Tickets available at redcarpetsouljam.com.
Hey, this is your man, DJ Herky Rock from the DJ Herky Rock Show, and just want to talk to you ladies. I ain't trying to be funny, but are you feeling bloated? Feel a little sluggish? Do you need to jumpstart your weight loss? Do you want to get rid of that purge before you put on that cute sundress this weekend? Well, check this out. Let me wrap you, all right? You need to get a few inches off your waist so you can stay slim in your swimsuit? Let's wrap, sweetheart. Wraps can be applied to tighten, tone, and firm any of your problem areas from your neck down. It's the It Works product. That's right. It can be applied to tighten, tone, and firm any of your problem areas from anywhere in your body.
Hey, what's up?
Make sure you call 404-850-1298. That's right. 404-850-1298. It's It Works. Hey, and the best part is you can even still get your groove on. It's the It Works products. That's
for okay, let me do this. Let me do this.
1298.
I will call you after. Give me an hour.
And make sure you tell them DJ Hercules. All right. You.
And if you can remember this, go to oldschool101.com and you can listen to the show.
All you have to do is download the TuneIn app, save it onto your smartphone, and then type in the name of the station you're listening to, and that's it. How cool is that? Anytime, any place, and anywhere. The TuneIn app from this station in the Aquarius 7 Broadcasting Network.
You're listening to the Captain and Company Morning Show.
They're Americans!
Back with more in 15 seconds or less.
I need another.
Hey everybody, this is the Street Certified Dope Doctor Louis Delgado from The Couch Live on WJHM, 102jams.com. We have a golf tournament coming up, and I just want everybody to go ahead and save the date for the Now Matters More Foundation. It's our fourth annual golf tournament coming up March 13th. You will have us, everybody here from Now Matters More Foundation, The Couch Live radio program. Daryl Strawberry will be there with us again this year. Curtis Luskanic from the Boston Red Sox, 2004 champions, and a host of others. So please, save the date, March 13th. The team will be at Aliqua again for our fourth annual golf tournament. See you then.
Now back with more hits with the Captain.
It's going down.
Captain and Company in the morning.
Do you realize what effect this will have on the American people?
Somebody call 911.
Oh boy. What a show on Veterans Day. We're going to get back in the mix right here on Captain Company. God knows what I'll put on next, to tell you the truth. But I do know this much. Happy Veterans Day.
Absolutely.
Planet Rock, Mississippi, Planet Lake. All of the sexy coming on a jump and skip. This Planet Rock, Mississippi, Planet Lake.
You're listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill in the mix.
Treat me good, don't mind your non drive me crazy. Don't move me, make your dumb it. I'm arrested. Press me close to old boy, don't be me. Independent, don't drive your own up here. Africa, no man, never superstar. Follow me, no. Planet are up, is where the planet are jump.
Question for you.
Yes, sir.
Give me a minute.
Right.
Do you happen to have another remote by any chance?
Yeah.
Now,
for that one?
No, for these.
Oh, yeah.
If you could do that, boy, look at here. I would be in. I owe you a favor.
Yeah, let me. What is it? These two are connected to that TV in there?
And this one? Come on, there you go. This is the hard part. It's to try to mix, and I'm listening and watching at the same time. That's how it's going to end. This is going to end first. Okay.
Yeah.
15 seconds. Shit! That's alright, go.
So get your credit swagger on.
You're listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill in the mix. You're listening.
Wow. He says, come on, come on. Watch it.
No bench, no stink, no sweat.
Can you put it right here with them? Or do you like to have a background?
Because we... Aaron. Get comfortable.
I was a sports guy. He hired me for a sports show. And then he threw me into the music. But I really was a sports guy.
Do you have the other card for the event?
Yeah.
What's up, everybody? It's Eric with Art420. I want you guys to come out Thanksgiving weekend. Art420, the second annual cannabis-inspired art show. It's free and open to the public. Just go to our website, www.art420.com. That's 420 spelled out. Check us out.
Songs over. Okay. Oh, you got anything over there? Anything over there? Okay. I'm gonna play this long bed. Stuff I gotta need. And now.
I can smell it strong. Right.
I think we are.
I caught a whiff earlier, but then I was like, no, that couldn't be.
Okay. Oh. Here we go. We're talking about that.
Caught a nice whiff.
From the left to the right. They smoking out back tonight. Somebody got that. They firing up the brimstone. Who is it?
Yes, they are.
We get the whiff over here.
We're in the studio right now. The breeze just passed by, and all we smelled was green goodness.
You know, you got a puff-puff pass around here. You didn't know that? That's the rule in the neighborhood. You got a puff-puff pass. Captain Company, a big salute. Hold on. I got the camera a little off here. There you go. There you go now. A big salute to my veterans out there. Yes, you even see I got... Oh, this what side? The captain. Yeah, it's on. Yeah, now see now I'm an official.
Captain. I salute you.
I salute you too, and I salute whoever's smoking that. You better bring that across the fence now, Uncle Paulie. That's what you need. Get you a little bit of down in there. You know.
I'll tell you right now. I had tons of my secondary smoke in the 70s in New York. In college, I used to go to the cafeteria and get stoned just from the secondary smoke. I went to a Rolling Stone concert in Madison Square Garden. There was so much smoke, I couldn't see the people on the other side of the arena.
Oh,
conditioning off full blast. It was incredible. I remember I came home from that concert, my mom's, you were supposed to go, no, Mom, it was a secondary school.
Oh, my goodness. We've got Elby, the intern in studio.
Yes, sir.
We've got our rapping friend. What is this rapping?
From DirecTV. Be ready.
Be ready from DirecTV, hanging out with us. Uncle Paulie in studio, also Eric from Art 420.
Yes.
So, Eric, take it away. What do you got going on, brother?
You know, again, on this Veterans Day, I definitely want to announce a project that we have with Art 420. One of the things we do at the art show, all of the artwork will be for sale, and we take a portion of those proceeds, and we have an art project called Battle for Freedom. And the Battle for Freedom project is a wall mural that we're dedicating to military veterans suffering from PTSD and bringing cannabis into the conversation as a viable treatment alternative for them. Again, we have all this information about the art show, about the brunch, about the Veterans Day event. All of that is on our website at art420.com. Again, that's 420 spelled out. And you can, you know, find all the information on that. We also accept donations. So if you're a military veteran or a family from a military veteran, you know, please go onto the website, check it out, come to the event. The Sunday of the art show, we will actually do an auction where we auction off some artwork again to raise some funds for that Battle for Freedom project.
Okay, that's a good thing. Paulie, why are you hiding in the corner?
I'm back.
You're like you in the cut. Before I get to you,
he's dozing off from the second hand.
I'm alert.
Okay, Elvin, I know you got something going on. Let's go ahead and turn the mic over to you real quick.
Actually, dope. I was just reading on a very interesting story, and I do want to get your guys' opinion on it, I guess I should say. Now, everybody's familiar with the Kardashians, right?
Right.
So, Rob Kardashian, Blac Chyna, had a baby. Blac Chyna was pregnant for 9 months. She just had her baby, I believe, today. They posted 4 hours ago, posted a picture of the baby. Mm-hmm. Now, there's a lot of controversy behind him because he has this sock line called Arthur George. That took him kind of a little while to get it together, but hey, I'm with people. Hey, you want to be an entrepreneur, want to have your business out there, do your thing. Now, this is the controversy. How would you guys feel about your child wearing a pair of socks that say Thug Life?
I mean, the Kardashians is a crazy vortex life anyway, so I don't think it really matters.
Yeah, I mean, as a parent, I'm entitled to, I'm inclined to allow parents to parent how they feel best. It's hard as a parent to be able to tell another parent what they should and shouldn't do. But, you know, my child wouldn't wear any Thug Life socks.
Chris?
See, that's the problem with America right now. See, look, give me that damn belt. We got to beat that ass. What's wrong with these kids now? They need a damn ass whooping. Whoop that ass. And get them stretched. Whoop that damn ass. You gotta beat that ass, baby. Beat that ass.
Take it to the mix.
Hell out of me.
can't do it to do the DirecTV. I got it to do the volume, but I can't do it to do the DirecTV. It won't do it for some reason.
Okay.
It'll only do the volume.
But at least that one will do the...
This one will do the volume on that one too. But it'll... You can change the channel on that one. I just can't do it on here.
Okay, that's fine. Great, thank you.
So you got two remotes in there now. This one's the only one that'll do the volume though. The other one won't do it.
Okay.
Alright, I'm out of here.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
No problem.
I can't wait to see you working with Elvis.
It was nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too.
Thanks for having me on.
Where's my cards? Hold on. Where we at? Oh. Alright.
Have a good one.
You too. I need, where we at? 39. Wow.
This is Dale Robinson from Sugar Land, Texas. I start my mornings with Captain and Company on oldschool101.com.
This is what he needs to do. He needs to make this longer. This song is the bomb.
There had to be a lot of people in here. It's like, there's nowhere to park. What's this today? That's your daily.
Oh, this
you
is
way that every day.
This is Veterans Day. You and I gotta talk after the show.
Hey,
you tell him the cat wants to talk to him pronto, 43 after the hour. Happy Veterans Day to all my veterans, Army, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, even those who served for Generalissimo Pancho Villa. Oh, honey, street certified dope doctor Louis Delgado hanging out. He's getting ready to go live on the couch in a few minutes. You can check him out on the Problem Solving Network, even though his web guy hasn't bothered to call me, but that's a whole other discussion. And we could talk about that for days. We could talk about other discussions that have gotten me into big trouble all week, but that's why we're still here and breathing. Eric! from Art 420 in the house. Also, Eddie the intern here. Uncle Paulie's got a story or two, but before we get into all of this, I must remind you, MLR, Automotive Customer Appreciation Party, tomorrow, Saturday, November the 12th, 10 to 2, right here on the corner of Old Hal Branch Road and Loma. We've got tickets for the Orlando Magic versus the New Orleans Pelicans. We also are giving away tickets for the Ford EcoBoost 300, which is next Friday evening down in Homestead. Also, we're now, you're giving us tickets to give away for the...
I'll give you some tickets to give away for the Black Market Brunch as well.
Wow!
Wow!
Wow! We're Ticketmaster Mammy over here! So, we've got all of these things going on. It's a free barbecue. Also, get your car looked at. Good friends at MLR Automotive, proud sponsor of Capman Company. Next week, 6 o'clock on... Well, first of all, Paulie goes to check out the Texans on Sunday the 13th. The International Association of Amusement Parks, IPA, is in town. Oh, boy, we're going to have some fun on Monday and Thursday next week. Going to Cotton Candy Sweet and Low. Hanging out with the... Well, I ain't going to sing the rest of it. You can just imagine. Tuesday, Elva the intern got her Indie Jam show on WJHM102Jams.com. Wednesday, 6 p.m., major announcement. Jazz in the Garden. We will tell you all 10 groups that will be performing at Jazz in the Gardens. All 10 of them. 6 o'clock on Wednesday, the 16th. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we're down south for the races at Homestead, the final race for NASCAR for the year. The 23rd at 6 o'clock, we kick off the Turkey Day Throwdown in the mix from 6.01 p.m. Wednesday, all day Thursday, all day Friday, all day Saturday, all day Sunday. Then I think we should be ready to announce there's a big change coming to oldschool101.com. A big change is a coming to oldschool101.com. And when you hear what we're going to do, people are going to rejoice coast to coast. They're going to go, wow. You guys are doing what? Wow. You can still listen for your favorites, but believe me, when I tell you what we're adding to the... Wow! Then, of course, in December, we got the 12 Days of Christmas. We always do that. Then we're talking about in January, Tampa Bay Black Heritage Festival. February, we've got not only my birthday, but the Daytona 500 to deal with. We've also got the Pro Bowl we will be involved in. In March, the 4th Annual Charity Golf Tournament with the Street Certified Dope Doctor Louis Delgado. We've also got Jazz in the Gardens. We've got the Orlando Jazz Festival. I don't hear nobody else. Oh, and I forgot to even tell you about Keith Sweat in February we have. And we also have Mike Epps and Bruce Bruce in February. How you like me now? Look. Mash the gas and ride. Captain Company's going to be off the chain in 2017. Oh, and did I also forget to tell you about video, live, streaming video, two-camera mix? I forgot that. So you need to tell your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, folks from the past, folks from the present, and folks in the future that we off the chain. Uncle Paulie,
yes, sir.
Can you give me some news in 3 minutes or less?
Yeah, in Anaheim, California, it was a really disturbing thing yesterday. A mother had her son was out in front of the house, and these two dogs came up and started attacking him. So she ran in there. She couldn't get her keys to get in the deck. So she's there in her shorts, and you bang, fending off these two dogs, wanting to rip her kids to shreds. I mean, it's a video thing. They got up a closed-circuit camera. It's really disturbing. Her son had to go to hospital and get all kind of stitches on his face and everything, but she got all bit up too, trying to keep these dogs off her child. I mean, I don't know why these dogs
wanted to rip this kid apart. I don't know if they thought he was a squeaky toy or what.
No, they thought the kid was Republican and voted red. That's what it was. Okay.
Another story I got is that they're saying that Trump might have to build a wall after all, because the Mexicans are saying now that he's president, they have no desire to come over here now.
He said he's gonna come to America! You! Donald Trump! You! Yeah, that's what they're saying. Alright, anything else, Paulie?
No, that's it.
Alright. 49 after the hour. What are we gonna pull? Let's go, let's get some low beats in here. How about... You know what, Paulie? It's starting to get a little hot in here. Maybe I have to get out of this outfit. Captain Company! Freestyle Friday! Happy Veterans Day! You know what? Come on. I love it. I got tickets for that. Come on. Every time I'm in the front of the side, getting money, getting everybody water. Okay. You know one shot we didn't hear from today?
You're listening to resident mixologist Captain Chris Hill in the mix.
Oh, look. The phone is blowing up.
Alright. Alright, let's get out of here. I've had enough fun for one day. Or did they really meet for tea?
Who's that? President and Trump?
They probably had cocktails.
Yeah, I'm sure that meeting had at least some alcohol involved.
There was some alcohol, yeah.
I heard your commercial the other day.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Okay. 95.3, I think.
Okay, yeah.
They're good. I heard that. Like, I'll see what you no matter what, brother. No worries. Is that why he brought you in today? Because you made me?
Yeah.
Where is it? It doesn't smell like anything.
You missed the smell. Somebody outside.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we got it. He's our
reviewer. Hi. You've been doing good.
I am.
Proud of you.
Flight attendants will be coming through the aisles to do their final safety checks.
If you have any remaining service items, please pass those to the aisles at this time. Thank you.
Are you producing some show?
What can I say? I'm a blast from the past.
All right, parting shot. Let's go from the left to the right. Elvie, where you at? I know you're behind me somewhere. Yeah. You're just hiding out. Where's your camp? Where's your camp?
There
you go.
I'm here. I'm here. Listen, right. Thanks for having me on the show today. I'm going to stick around for a little bit, check out the couch live. And also, I just want to wish everybody out there a happy Veterans Day to all the courageous people who serve their country.
Okay, very good. I like that. Happy Veterans Day. Where is Eric?
All right. Thanks again, Chris, for having me here. You know, Art 420, second annual cannabis-inspired art show coming up this Thanksgiving weekend, November 25th through 27th at the Hanau Contemporary Center. Free and open to the public. Go to our website, art420.com. Again, that's 420 spelled out, art420.com, and you can register for tickets. Happy Veterans Day to all of the veterans out there who serve proudly. Thank you.
Paulie, party shot.
And I want to make sure all the veterans, they go and get your perks. You can go to Olive Garden, Golden Corral. Go and get your free meals. You earned it. You deserve it.
Yes, and you're absolutely right. Veterans, we want to salute you, especially my mom, the CEO. Thank you for your service. And military brats, this is our day too now. This is our day too because we serve too. Oh, yeah. So we salute you. And with that said, can we get the hell out of here? I'm tired. Damn, I was 4 seconds off.
After a wonderful landing, we would like to be the first to welcome you back to Orlando, Florida. We will be taxiing for a few minutes. Please remain seated with your seatbelt securely fastened until the aircraft returns to the gate and the captain has turned off the back seatbelt card. We also need to keep the aircraft and hearing on that for the right to the temperature focus.
Paul, up and out, up and out. We got to change.
Please be sure to check your seatback pocket bathroom.
Oh, wait, these are all the veterans' perks. My brother-in-law serves over in Japan. He's a Navy diver. He's pretty serious out there.
I'm trying to think.
I don't know. My dad has a list that he goes to.
The all day, spend the all day.
I'm waiting.
I'm holding up the show right now.
I'm going to work.
I'm going to work.